the preferred combination on the Korean side. Sha Sha to start. Oh, this angle here from Sha Sha. She was in the air when she hit it. On the move, air Sha Sha flying through the court. Opening spin, and as wide as can be.
Love two.
Control here, the Chinese pair getting their start. Shin Yubin, but they take the point, and the Korean fans will make themselves heard. Good cover in the middle there from Jun Ji-hee. Nice bend from Shin Yubin. Taped up quite a bit on that left leg, Jun Ji-hee.
3-1.
Beautiful forehand flick up on one foot, using that height to her advantage for the reach. Perfect placement in the touch game to get Sha Sha to play defensively from short on the forehand, or backhand side, rather. So tied up here now. Take a look, soft spin on the opening. The Korean pair create that opening, keeping the opponents, the both right-handed players, in the deep backhand corner. You'll see this happen from time to time throughout the match. That will be the mission of the Korean pair. Easier said than done. Good read of the shovel serve. Sha Sha just spins it for control. Sha Sha offering a little bit of an apology there to Wang Manyu. Felt that she could have put the pair in a better position. Soft shot. Leaves Shin Yubin over the table for the attack once again. Leveled at 4 points apiece now. Well, now, Jun Ji-hee to play this shot. If you follow her on Instagram, you've seen all the yoga she does, and it comes out to pay off here. Downward dog, upward scoreboard. And a 2-point advantage right now, the Korean pair. We've seen many pairs and many opponents against the best in the world from Team China starting off strong, but it's the end game. It's whoever crosses the line first. First of three games here in this best of five.
6-5.
Tactically speaking, anything the Korean pair can do to keep the ball short and low and to keep Wang Manyu and Sun Yingsha off the attack, because once they open, they are so strong, so fast, and so well prepared, in position, ready for another shot to come back. Fired up as can be, they know how crucial these moments are. In the semifinal we just saw with the men before this, the Korean pair came quite close. They took game number one, and then after that, it was two in a row for the Chinese pair, but six of the last eight here have been won by Shin Yubin and Jun Ji-hee. The Koreans strong right now, edging towards the finish line in game one.
5-8.
Shin Yubin catching her feet there. Thought, if the ball comes over the net, I need to make sure I get it from the ground if I have to. Watch how quickly she moves. Ooh, that left ankle. She's fine. Looked like it could have been bad, though.
8-6.
Sorry, Coach Oh in the corner now. Coach Hwang last game for Korea. Last match, rather. Last game as well, for that matter. There's a lot to play for here. A World Championships title is a World Championships title. Perfectly played on the line there to the backhand. Shin Yubin taking her chances, and Jun Ji Hee contributing well along the way. Second serve here for Jun Ji Hee.
7-5.
So a much needed point here for Wang Manyu and Sun Ying Sha, who now have the serves on their side. Sha Sha, just like we started this match. Shin Yubin gets the racket high, and the work that Jun Ji Hee put in paid off. 3 game points. Nice flick there. And a short stroke for a quick answer. Timing here. This is amazing. What a point to finish on. The teamwork in this round. We're sitting in it right now, but Jun Ji Hee, it's all paid off. Good recovery from Shin Yubin. The Chinese pair continuing to follow up on their fortune and secure the point. So a little look at Jun Ji Hee, flexibility there. Oh, she got low. Scorekeeper Booth in the way, but she got low.
Oh, 3, love.
Turns out that International Yoga Day is actually June 21st. I accidentally typed in International Yoda Day. I'm sure the Star Wars fans can let me know when that is on the calendar. 0-3 right now, the Korean pair. And Wang Manyu and Sun Ying Sha, the world number one, leaving nothing to regret here, but just paving the way in the future, starting game number two flawlessly. The placement on this one, testing the wingspan. Wang Manyu with the backhand, as Shin Yubin starts to just lean to turn that backhand corner and play the forehand.
5-1.
Shin Yubin has been very impressive for me. Jun Ji Hee has been the leader for the Korean women for some time now, but Shin Yubin, the younger of the two by many years, really showing what she's made of here. I think the quality of the backhand in that rally shows me that she's capable of a whole lot, a very bright future ahead. Angle all day long, Jun Ji Hee steps around and sends it wide. Quick move, opens the shoulders, really turns to hit the inside of that ball to add some side spin to the top spin, some insult to injury. A page out of the Hina Hayata handbook here. Slow spin from Shin Yubin. If you were watching with us when Hina Hayata played Wang Yidi, my condolences to the Chinese fans. My congratulations to everyone else. Right down the line, Jun Ji Hee turns the corner so quickly. Quick decision, and when the free hand comes up, you know that's going to be trouble. Little secret time here for Sha Sha. She keeps the hands cool. little discussion about how to receive, what the plan is. Much needed point by the Korean pair. Remember, they were down 0-4 and then got four out of the next 5 points. Shasha covering the table well despite being on the move back into the center of the table. A lot of mixed emotions in that facial expression we just saw. Not easy to do, focused as can be. I thought Wang Manyu surely had secured the point here. Handcuff down low, spins it low and shallow, and Shin Yubin several times now has made really impressive shots. 1 point game. Clever play here from Shasha. Racket closed, not a full swing, just guides it back and keeps a little topspin on it. Short serve. Again, if you're newer to table tennis, players will signal in doubles not only what they're planning to serve or what they want for a serve. Here, Shin Yubin, it's more common that way. The waiting player says, here's what I'd like you to serve to get me a third ball. The plan works out, still trailing here, but if the Koreans can come back and take this, they've got a 2-0 lead. In a best of five, they'd be one game away from a place in the final. And in terms of momentum, the Korean pair here with 75% of the last 8 points.
8-6.
That said, still two between them. The Chinese pair fighting to hang on after that 4-0 lead. Trying to keep each other calm here. Good placement. Shasha forces Jun Ji-hee to pull back that left leg to create a little room for the forehand. Where did this one come from? Jun Ji-hee had her mind made up. She recognized quite early. And this is the thing, when you have a pair that are both right-handed, it's a clever, clever pattern. Still had to be risky right to the line, that look of satisfaction as they stared each other in the eyes to confirm that their plan was good. And a nice change of pace. Jun Ji-hee with the soft spin shot ties it up. It's going to say tactically, you hit it right back at the player who just hit the ball. This is one of the first things you learn because you have to alternate shots. You can use the opponents who just played as an obstacle. At this level, it's rarely possible to do so effectively as Jun Ji-hee has done with Shin Yubin. 8 points apiece. Extra deep, nice placement here from Shasha. Ball sits up a little bit. Everything in on this one. Again, the flexibility that we see from Jun Ji-hee to make this forehand shot takes a lot out of the midsection. Just keep your eyes on Jun Ji-hee's waist for this. Still, her upper body is attached to her lower body after that shot. Impressive. Stressful? Sure. But it ties up the score at 9 points apiece. Here's Coach O. Watching closely. Yellow card's gonna come on this one for time wasting. Sure enough, there it is. The Korean pair taking a little bit of extra time on the receive.
9-0.
goes low to the ground. Once again, a sweeping leg, Karate Kid style out here as Jung Ji-hee sets up a game points. Beautiful inside out. Look how quickly she's back up on her feet, just in case she needed to be back up. The fighting spirit here, and it is now game point. There it is, the open table. Jung Ji-hee works hard. So racket clean, Jung Ji-hee on the receive. Some clear determination here. Wang Manyu makes her way forward to deal with the side spin on this brushing backhand. Touch play, point for point. They want to have a strong early start. Heavy spin comes in. And the placement just right. So remember, the serves are backwards on screen, as is the yellow card. The yellow card belongs to the Korean pair. Kick him when he's down, as the song goes. When you've got your opponent in a tough position, don't give them a chance to find confidence. Right now, the Koreans not looking for any more games in this match than they need. Just this one. Back edge of the table. Some guarded cheers here. No way. Two chops in a row from the Koreans. When have you ever seen Jung Ji-hee chop in your life? I've been watching Jung Ji-hee for what feels like the better part of a decade. A chop from Shin Yubin with side spin and the opposite side spin back. Channeling their inner Xu Xin's out here. The Korean pair get the first point out of their opponent's timeout, but they have to be careful about taking too much time. That is just perfection. Swinging shot with the finishing shot as wide as can be. The Koreans ran like there was nothing else to do in life. Chased full extension and slapped, but that one out of reach, even for the tall Shin Yubin. Control there, just flexes up a little bit, pulls up on the bicep to keep the top spin on. Sha Sha keeping it cool. First towel break here, 2 points between them. It's a very unusual point. The Chinese pair controlling the footwork on the other side with an off-pace shot from behind the table nonetheless, Wang Manyu. Guiding it back around, sees Jung Ji-hee way behind the table, doesn't try to rip it. Says, I'll give you a chance from that far back to play it out in front a little bit. Two in a row here for the Chinese pair. What an angle, Jung Ji-hee finds it once again, a left-handed bread and butter. Just smoothly spreading it there. Take a look, push baseline. And exiting the side of the table, Jung Ji-hee shares a clinched fist with Shin Yubin. Guarded optimism, though, as they both need to stay fully focused in what is becoming quite a tight game number three. Tied up, 5 points apiece. Remember, it is must win for the Chinese pair. Beautiful flick from Shin Yubin, but Wang Manyu with a nice response. Ooh. Fun reaction there from Jun Ji-hee. First time seeing a fly. Like, ooh. What is that thing? The streak continuing here. If the Chinese pair, the world number ones, can pull out this game, they'll have momentum, they'll have confidence. Second serve here. Jun Ji-hee, he asks for a new ball, recognizing something wrong with that one. They do select the balls before the match. This shot is outstanding. She recognizes right away that she's got room for this full swing. Underspin serve, soft push, and as soon as the long push comes out, Jun Ji-hee, with those wide feet, that low stance, fully commits to stepping around. Just cleaning the racket there again. Chinese setup, that forehand, and the blade for that matter. Both of the Korean pair are using a Chinese setup.
Six.
Edging ahead. Trouble right now. Wang Manyu looking back. Take another look here. Long push and Jun Ji-hee quick to move in. Goes deep to the backhand corner of Sha Sha. Shaking in the corner here with satisfaction. The tension right now after pegging Wang Manyu in the middle. It is all chase and defense here, but now the offense comes back out. Look how low Wang Manyu gets, goes to the ground, and still Jun Ji-hee has the answer. The athleticism, the spectacle here. These women flying all around the deep backcourt of the game. She served long to Wang Manyu. She served long and Wang Manyu takes a ripping opening, and what does Jun Ji-hee do? It is not an easy ball to deal with. A backhand off the bounce, counters it and swings through it. This is not a block. You would be advised to block that. Rarely would somebody swing. Had she missed that shot, someone would have told her to calm down, but she made it. And now the Koreans, 2 points away from a massive upset over the world number one. Deja vu, look at this. It is now 4 match points for the Korean pair to move on over the world number one. And just to confirm and correct myself from earlier, the yellow card is the Chinese pair's. They were stalling when they were in trouble. The Korean pair was on screen, so I misunderstood. Here it is. And they've taken it! 11-6, the Koreans have...